Hello, hello, it's Jang here with a look at the First Order Snowspeeder, a LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens set that comes with 444 pieces, believe it or not. Comes with the three minifigures that are shown right there. I personally think that the vehicle or craft, whatever you want to call it, doesn't make that much sense just to look at it at first glance without figures in it. So let me put some figures in it. So that's the general idea there. Two seats in the back with nice seat rests, or back rests for them, and then a turret position up at the front, a gunner position. Now, unfortunately, this gun is not able to turn side to side. There's no pivot there. It's only able to go up and down. You can also kind of go back and forth just a little bit to bring it in to the shoulder. It's basically just a mounted heavy blaster. Kind of a probably just an upgraded version of the classic one. Has a stud shooter on the top, so you can actually shoot something out. Kind of looks like it's in the position of a sight, but I think that works out good, so you're still able to have a nice built up long barrel there. These are, I believe, supposed to be the actual cannon barrels, the main blasters on the front of the thing, but instead of putting something that actually shoots over there, they went all out. They gave you a six shooter on this side, and they gave you a six shooter on this side. They built them into the fronts of the engines. I think on the real, I keep saying the real thing, which is kind of a nonsensical thing to say, but the in movie, the in universe design, I think all of this is just engine pod here, but LEGO integrated the six shooters here, which are activated from back here to turn the trigger mechanism around. So this thing can really just shoot off a wall of studs if you grab both of those at the same time. So lots and lots of shooting action towards the front. You notice it does use some stickers, so stickers going around the sides. It was a pretty nice build. It has a lot of pieces that build up in layers, really. These on the sides here are, I believe they're supposed to represent air brakes. I think they're used as air brakes, but they can also be used as vents if things start to get overheated a little bit. Small little sticker right there. I very much do like what they did with the backrests and the seats and the little pod section there. I'll actually take this guy out so you can see that a little bit better, like so. Yeah, I think that just looks good. Got grill pieces used on the back, grill pieces used on the front there. More of the same stickers around the sides. And this does have wheels on the bottom, these Technic clear wheels to allow it to just roll around on the ground. And they're nice and close together, so you can actually get this thing to turn on the ground. So that works out pretty well. But most of the space of the deck here, I mean, you get some space for your two passenger, well, your pilot and one passenger back here. But most of the space here is just for transporting studs. These are three cases that are completely full. Well, not completely full, but they're primarily used to just hold studs. More studs to put into your six shooters on the sides, so you can just spray those things all over the entire house. Not just the room, but the entire house, because that's what ends up happening with those things. They do give you the spots for the three included figures to hang up their weapons. So two clips right there, and then one clip over here. And that pretty much does it for the features of the Snowspeeder itself. Taking a closer look at the figures, these snow troopers are all the same, except for a very small detail. The one on the left isn't just a snow trooper, he's a First Order snow trooper officer. So he gets the patch going across the right shoulder, which looks pretty good, looks pretty appropriate. These all get the little printed pack on the back on a black small thin bracket piece. Get some traditional blasters there. The one on the left has just a white lightsaber hilt added onto it. Unfortunately, underneath the helmets, these are all just Angry Clone, which is kind of uninspired and also potentially canonically nonsensical. Don't think that there should be any clones left, but I haven't seen the movie yet because it hasn't come out as of the time of this video. I want to take off the backpack just so that you can see the rest of the detail of the print on the back of that torso. There's not a lot to see there, but it's worth showing. My personal favorite detail on these figures is this pair of indents on the side of the helmet. You get that on either side, and I don't know why, I just like how that looks. The rest of it is, it's okay. It's pretty good for the source material. I'm just not a big fan of the source material, the real things in the movie. Without a doubt, this is my least favorite of the first wave of brick-based The Force Awakens sets from LEGO. I just think that it should have been a much smaller set and thus a cheaper set. Still could have accomplished the vast majority of the functionality here and also the look. I just feel like it doesn't need all this building up to just hold three dudes and some studs. And yes, it shoots forward, that's nice, but again, I really think it just could have been a much smaller set, closer in overall size to the smallest, the Rey speeder. Not quite that small, but still, I think that I think the value is actually on a price per part basis for what's actually built here is okay. It's not great, it's not terrible, it's okay. But I think that this should have been a smaller and cheaper set that more people would have been able to get, and that would have been more useful for massing troops, just getting a bunch of those snow troopers, if that's something that you want to get. Let me know how you feel about this set, what you think about the figures, what you think about the value, and what you think about just the design of the craft here and how LEGO has done with it. I've got a lot more videos on the way, so stay tuned, and I'll be talking to you again soon.